In this video, I'm going to show you two great features of Quick Edit that you can access when you're in a CSS file. The first great thing about Quick Edit is that you can edit your CSS while in the HTML, so you don't have to jump back and forth between the files. But if you go into the CSS file, you can access two other parts of the Quick Edit functionality, the Color Picker and Transition Editor. I'm still in pc.html and have Live Preview running. I'm going to go to a notes div and start up Quick Edit with Command plus E and get to the correct rule. This rule is setting the color right here. And if I hover over the color, I see a color swatch, which is nice. But I want to get to the color picker. You get to the color picker with the Quick Edit shortcut, but I can't do it when I'm inside of the Quick Edit screen. However, if I go to the CSS file by clicking on the link, I can get my cursor on the color and start up the Quick Edit again. Now the color picker pops up. This is a pretty powerful color picker. You can use your arrow keys to move the picker around, and you can tab to the sliders and use the arrow keys again to go up and down and change the hue and transparency. Notice that the live preview is updating all the time. Of course, you can use your mouse if you prefer that way of picking a color. You can see the new color compared to the old right here. You can also tab to the RGBA, hex, and HSLA buttons and pick how you want the color represented in your CSS. One of my favorite things about this is how it's showing other colors in your projects. You can tab over to them and pick one. I'll quit this with Escape. The other neat thing you can do with Quick Edit is edit your CSS transitions. I don't really have anything to transition on this page, so I'll do a temporary transition on the logo image. I'll go to the image and add position of relative and top of 0 so that we can change its position when we hover over the image. Then I'll add a different position on hover so that the image drops 50 pixels when you hover over it. It's annoying, but it will be good for our demonstration. Now I'll add a transition to the top property with a duration of 1 second. I'm making it slow so we can really see it. I didn't specify a transition timing function, and the default value for that is ease. You can see that the transition starts and stops gradually. It speeds up a bit in the middle. If I change the timing function to linear, it changes its position in a linear fashion, which doesn't feel very natural. Now here is the fun Quick Edit part. I can hit Quick Edit and it gives me the transition curve editor. You can see a linear transition is just a straight line, but we can change that here. Just like the color picker, I can use the keyboard or mouse to edit the timing. I can grab the handles and create my own custom transition. If I make the curves go above and below the original lines, I get a little bit of a bounce at the beginning and end. Or I could create a drop effect when I pull both cursors down into the right corner. It's fun to play with the handles and experiment with different effects. Another way to transition something is not with a smooth transition, but instead with steps. If I change the timing function to, say, steps 4, the image will move to the new position in 4 steps. This is represented in the transition editor as well. It's telling me I can use the arrow keys to edit the steps. As I said, both of these features are part of the Quick Edit functionality, but you need to be in the CSS file to access them. If I'm in an HTML file with Quick Edit open and hit Quick Edit again to try to access the color picker, I'll actually toggle close the Quick Edit screen. But it's really not hard to click on the CSS link and get to the code and open up the color picker or transition editor if you need to. The last three videos have been a pretty comprehensive look at the Quick Edit feature in brackets. It's this feature that really sets brackets apart from other code editors and makes it more fun to use. In the next lesson, I'm going to talk about using the Live Preview Highlight option in brackets.